Well, hello, this is Chris from Recombu, and I'm here with the Sony Xperia XA2 Ultra, an absolute beast of a 6-inch smartphone launched just last month in sunny Las Vegas. And it's coming to the UK as an auto exclusive for 350 quid. We're going to do a quick side-by-side with last year's Xperia XA1 Ultra. It's still £300, so there's not a massive price difference at all between the two. See what has actually been updated and whether you should upgrade to this model if you got this model. So first of all, from a distance, as you can see, they basically look the same. Few little detail and differences, especially around the selfie camera area, which we'll touch on later. The thing is that they are basically the same size. They're both 6-inch smartphones. You've got ever so slightly smaller bezels above and below on the XA2 Ultra, but there's not much difference there at all. They both rock a gorgeous edge-to-edge design, as you can see there. Screen stretching from the left to the right side, which is very, very nice. Indeed, and they both pack quite a punch as well. They've got a good bit of heft to them. The XA2 Ultra weighs 221 grams, which makes it one of the heaviest smartphones we've ever reviewed, compared with the 188 gram, which is almost modest in comparison, from the XA1 Ultra. They both got a decent heft. You will definitely feel them when you're packing them in your pocket or your handbag or wherever you decide to shove them. Now, if we turn them both over, you'll see they sport a very similar sort of finish. They've both got this sort of polycarbonate back, but the XA2 Ultra has a nice it's more of a rounded finish to it, which you can hopefully make out on camera there. It just helps it fit in the palm a little bit neater, and it looks a bit snazzier as well. And it's also got some really nice detailing around the corners here. As you can see, a nice sort of chamfered bit of edge in there, nice and shiny. Whereas the old XA1 Ultra just looked a little bit sort of plasticky, doesn't it rock the same lovely aluminium edges as the XA2 Ultra. Not a massive difference again, but it's just the little details that really make a difference. And while last year's XA1 Ultra, as you can see there, a bit bare, a bit barren, no kind of fingerprint sensor at all on offer, you do actually get a scanner on the XA2 Ultra, right? Nice and centrally positioned, quick tap of that, and you're straight into your desktops. I see it straight, there is a bit of a brief delay, but nothing too major. So what about that display tech? Well, it's a 6-inch IPS display in both cases, and it's a 1920 by 1080 pixel resolution as well, so you'll get some nice sharp detailing when you dive in and look up nice and close, especially when watching HD movies and things like that, despite the fact that they are quite spacious panels. They're both on maximum brightness right now. Not the brightest panels around, but definitely fine for outdoor use. You won't have to be squinting to see what you're doing or anything like that, so it's all good. And the good news as well, if you dive into the display settings, Sony's usual super vivid mode is on offer there. So this is just a standard mode right here. If we dive into the settings, turn that on, and what it does is just gives colors a nice little boost, image enhancement, and it just really, really brings your photos and stuff to life and just makes everything really pop off the screen. Lovely stuff. Now, unfortunately, the XA1 Ultra is still rocking the old Android Nougat. So we dive down here, as you can see, Android version 7.0. It is due an update at some point. Not sure when. We are waiting very, very patiently for that one. But thankfully, you don't have to wait on the XA2 Ultra. Dive in here, you see we've already got Android version 8.0.0, so it's got full Oreo on it. Haven't noticed a massive amount of difference though, of course. A lot of the best Oreo updates are sort of behind the scenes stuff that you shouldn't really notice anyway. So they do rock a very similar feature set. So for instance, dive into the settings, you'll notice that they've both got, thankfully, a bit of one-handed operations mode, and that just really, really helps out with everyday use. It means that you can, for instance, minimize the display a bit just with a quick flick towards the middle of the screen, like so, and then you can reposition that when needed, and that just really, really helps with the general operation. If you have only got one hand to spare, you can pull down the notifications tab. I didn't do a very good job of that at all, did I? Let's try that again. Pull down the notifications tab. Ah, forget it. There we go. Hey, he gets it in the end. Great stuff. I love how I can never do it when I'm on camera. But beyond that, it is basically business as usual on both of them. You get the full complement of Google apps, and of course you get all of Sony's new stuff that's shoved on there as well. So for instance, their custom music, album, video apps, and of course you get the likes of Sony News, and of course a bit of PlayStation action as well. So you can connect up to your PS4 and use it as a second screen and see all your PS4 stats, see what your mates have been busy playing and so on. So what about the performance? Well, there's not a massive difference between the two, although it's definitely an upgrade for the XA2. You get the old MediaTek P20 in the XA1 Ultra. It still runs reasonably well. You'll see the odd little bit of jankiness, the odd juzzer, the odd stutter, especially when loading up an app. Sometimes it takes a little while to get going, but it gets there in the end. And we don't really see too much in the way of troublesome, you know, crashes, pauses, anything like that. It's generally behaved itself quite nicely. And the XA2 Ultra, it's gone for a bit of Qualcomm action. It's a Snapdragon 630 processor. In both handsets, you get 4 gigs of RAM as well, so that definitely helps with the everyday run, especially when you're nipping around between different apps. But generally, as I say, apps load up pretty quickly, and we've even been playing some games, and they all seem absolutely fine as well. Decent little frame rate out of it. Good stuff. And if you're a benchmarking fan, we've run the latest version of AnTuTu on both. And there is a bit of an upgrade, as you can see, 89,000. So you get around the 90,000 mark when you run it on the XA2 Ultra, whereas it was more around the 75,000 mark on the old XA1 Ultra. So there's a definite upgrade there. Good stuff. When it comes to the storage, there's no difference between these handsets whatsoever. You get a choice of either 32 or 64 gigs of space on both of these. I've got the 32 gig model in both cases. A large chunk of that is used up by the apps that you get pre-installed on there already. So unfortunately, you don't get a massive amount of space for your media and apps and all that. Thankfully, you can expand the storage on both of these blowers with a nice bit of micro SD action. It takes cards of up to 256 gigs in both cases, so that's always good if you need to cram on loads of HD movies and things like that. And of course, you get a nice bit of smart storage action on both of these phones as well, so you can quickly and easily free up a bit of space, just get rid of some of the crap that's logging there in the cache. There you go. Nothing on the XA2 Ultra, because that's obviously nice and fresh, but there almost certainly will be on this bad boy. So let's just get the smart cleaner on the go, and there you go, and that automatically gets rid of any rubbish. Now, surprisingly, the XA1 Ultra, despite being quite a sizable phone, only packed a 2700 milliamp battery, so it sort of just about lasts the day as long as you don't hammer it too hard. Thankfully, that's been massively upgraded in the XA2 Ultra, and you now get a huge 3580 milliamp cell. So far it's doing really, really well. It's only gone down about 8% in the past sort of 16 hours or so, despite the fact that we've been installing apps on it, benchmark testing, all that kind of thing. And hopefully we'll get a full 2 days of use between charges from that. The good news is that both phones, of course, pack a bit of stamina mode and ultra stamina mode, which just culls some features and just gives you a little bit of extra use out of the final dregs of battery if you really need it. In both cases, you get the smart QNovo tech as well, which just helps your phone to prevent damage over time from overcharging, which is definitely a great thing to have. It seems to do the job as well, because we haven't noticed any degradation in any of Sony's older phones that rock that tech. Definitely good. And you also get quick charging in both cases. You get MediaTek's own version of quick charging on the XA1 Ultra, and it's obviously Qualcomm's quick charge 3.0 on the XA2 Ultra. So what about that camera tech? Well, on paper, the rear camera certainly is more or less the same. As you can see, a little bit of a difference in terms of how long they took to load there. But they both rock a very similar camera app. They both rock a 23 megapixel XMO RS sensor, so you'd be forgiven for thinking it's basically the same camera. And they both rock a manual mode, superior auto mode, so you can shoot some nice snaps. They're pretty quick off the dot when you hit the old shutter button. And then you dive into the video mode, you can shoot a nice bit of video as well. But there are actually quite a few differences. The sensors are different, so you get better low light performance from the XA2 Ultra, or so we should anyway. We haven't done full testing yet, so don't take our word on that just yet. Stay tuned for our in-depth XA2 Ultra camera review coming soon. If you go into the video mode, you'll see that there's some differences there as well. If you go into the settings, for instance, video resolution, you can go up to full HD 60 frames per second on the XA2 Ultra, whereas sadly it tops out at 30 frames per second on the XA1 Ultra, so you don't get that nice ultra realistic finish. You also might notice this additional little icon down here next to the record button. That is the new slow motion feature, which is only on the XA2 Ultra, not on the XA1. And that shoots at 120 frames per second for some really, really nice crisp slow motion footage. Again, stay tuned for a full testing of that. And if we dive into the full camera features as well, you'll notice that you can do 4K video recording on the XA2 Ultra, which you sadly can't on the XA1 Ultra. It tops off at that full HD resolution. And as for that selfie camera, well, it's definitely got a major upgrade on the XA2 Ultra compared with the XA1 Ultra. So as you can see, there are actually two selfie cameras on the XA2 Ultra. You get a 16 megapixel effort with optical image stabilization built in, and you also get a secondary 8 megapixel effort with steady shot. And that's a 120 degree wide angle lens, so you can get some nice group selfies on the go or fit plenty of landscaping in behind you. You don't get that secondary camera on the XA1 Ultra, you just get the standard 16 megapixel with OIS. So if we load up the selfie camera on both cases, there we have it. Oh, eye direction, keep your eyes. Yes, got it. And of course, a nice bit of hand shutter action. So there you go. And you can actually skip between standard mode and group mode. Here we go, nice bit of wide angle. So there you go. So you've got that choice on the XA2 Ultra, which you don't get on the XA1. And of course, we'll be doing a full side-by-side comparison with those as well. So stay tuned for that. So that, in a dinky little nutshell, is the XA1 Ultra and the XA2 Ultra side by side. If you've got the XA1 Ultra, are you tempted by the XA2 Ultra? There are quite a few improvements in there. You get a little boost in performance. You get the new snazzy new camera tech, especially for your sexy selfies. And of course, boost in some various other areas, such as the battery life as well. So, plenty to ponder there. Only £50 between them as well. So if you're looking to buy a new handset, we definitely point you in this direction. Nice bit of XA2. So let us know what you think in the comments below. Thanks for watching, everyone. As always, I love you to the bottom of my heart. Goodbye.